Somebody was killing people on the streets of this Oklahoma City metro area. He had just killed a man at the front door and shot the wife in the face as she came running down the hall. He shot her in the face. So I was a patrolman for probably less than a year when they knew that I was an artist, that I painted and, you know, was doing things. And the captain of the police of the detective division said, "Harvey, do you think you could go talk to her and draw the man that killed her husband and shot her?" And I said, "Yeah, I think I could do that." So I did the drawing, and they had seen a car at the crime scene, and then they saw it in a neighborhood. And so they were taking that witness description drawing through the neighborhood and knocking on doors and talking to people. And they knocked on a door of a young girl, and she answered the door, and they showed her the painting, the drawing, and she said, "It's my husband. He's the one that you're looking for." I've always been involved in the culture for as long as I can remember. Even when I was born, before I was Harvey Pratt, I was Vihunchkis, which is Cheyenne, which means he wants to be a chief. So my first painting in high school at St. Patrick's Indian Mission, sold my very first painting, and I sold it for $90. $90 in 61 or 62 was a lot, was almost a half a month's salary. The money factor kind of counted a little bit, so he kind of made it possible, you know, that I could earn a little bit. So I did stuff in the Marine Corps. When I joined the Marine Corps, I did the guide on for our platoon, and I made PFC out of boot camp. And they sent me overseas as a member of the 3rd Marine Division Military Police. I've always been very proud of the Marine Corps and what I did in the Marine Corps, and also what I did in law enforcement. You know, I've done over 5,000 witness description drawings. I've done about 2,000 soft tissue reconstructions, cranial facial reconstructions, age progressions, and, you know, just little things like that that I stumbled across and was doing that nobody else was doing, you know. Next thing I know, people were calling me from all over the United States. What is the best case? And I say they're all best. They are all the best, you know. If I do something that catches somebody that abuses or rapes children and I catch him, that's the best. Or if I work on a case and I help catch a serial murderer, that's the best. To me, they all have value, and not only job security, but they give me a lot of job satisfaction.